Dear viewers, Drishti IAS presents to you a new program, Editorial Analysis. In this program, we will analyze editorials published in major English newspapers such as The Hindu, Indian Express, etc. for effective understanding of students. In this program, we will mainly focus on three things. First, establishing link of the editorial to UPSC syllabus. Second, understanding the main points of editorial under key points. And third, discussing important concepts mentioned in the editorial or which are necessary to understand the editorial. Hope you all like this new initiative of Drishti IAS. Please feel free to give your suggestions and opinions. Today's editorial appeared in The Hindu on 5th May and it's under the heading App for One Season, and it basically talks about the Arogya Setu app that has been made mandatory by the government for all the people inside the country so that government can easily track all the COVID-19 cases. However, there are certain issues with respect to this app, and this is where the editorial comes into play. Let's see UPSC syllabus linkage. You can link it with GS2 under Government Policies and Interventions and issues relating to development and management of social sectors, specifically health, education and human resources. Under GS3, you can link it with science and tech, developments and their applications and effects in everyday life, and awareness in the field of IT, computers. As mentioned before, the editorial highlights that Arogya Setu app has sparked concerns amongst all because it cannot be made mandatory without legal backing. Currently, government has made it mandatory for all the people who are venturing outside their homes to install this app so that government can easily track how the COVID-19 patients, if there comes a case that is positive, is interacting with other people, and it becomes easier to track all those who might have gotten infection. The center's national directive, which has been issued, makes it mandatory for use of Arogya Setu app for contact tracing as part of its COVID-19 combat measures. Apart from all other measures that government is taking, this is one of the most important measures to track how the infection is spreading in the community or among the people if they venture out of their homes. However, this app falls short of established legal standards for the protection of privacy. The certain issues with respect to this Arogya Setu app is, first, if you look back to the KS Puttaswamy judgment, which was given by Supreme Court, and it has laid down certain conditions with respect to use of any such app or any concerns relating to privacy, this app particularly fails in the first test itself. Government cannot make use of any app involuntary until and unless there is a law authorizing it. So government should have first brought out a legal backing, that is, there should have been a law before government can go on to make its usage compulsory and ask everybody to mandatorily install the app. Currently, there is no such law. Moreover, government has no power to make the app's use compulsory without legislative authorization. We just spoke about it. And there is no legislative guidance on the part of government that once you install the app, what would be its purpose, what would be its functioning, and the nature of use of sensitive personal data that you shared through the medium of this app, and what would happen in the long run once the COVID-19 pandemic is over. How are you going to use that data in the future? That is, government is going to use that data. What if that data is not secure enough? What if it gets compromised? Going by the directive issued under Disaster Management Act, this is the act under which the government is taking all the measures to fight the COVID-19. Under this act, the government has issued directions with respect to people residing in containment zones that all government and public sector staff and all employees, whether public or private employees, those who are allowed to work during the lockdown, will have to download the app. Apart from downloading the app, you will also have to keep the phone's location and Bluetooth on at all times. So these are the directives that have been given by the government. However, lawyers and activists have raised concerns over privacy and also an assessment made on basis of information collected that in future may be used to restrict public movement and access to various public places for whatever reasons. But once the data is compromised or once the data is going to be used against you, if there are concerns, then certainly these have to be paid attention to. There is also an absence of sunset clause in the use of app. That is, it doesn't mention for how long is government making the use of this app, even if the purpose of app is over with respect to COVID-19. Once we are through this pandemic, What would happen to all the data that government would have collected by now? And is there any sunset clause that this, once the app runs out of its use, will it become obsolete? Would government delete all the data, or it would retain the data? So there is no clarity over there also. Some people also fear that it can become a surveillance tool in the hand of government. Surveillance tool means then government can actually be like a big brother who's eyeing your movement 24/7, and you have no control over it. There is no concern of privacy, and there is nothing that is now protected from the government. The government would become the big brother. Now, from here onwards, what can government do? Obviously, since COVID-19 is there, you cannot just leave it to the people to take the necessary measures of safety. We do need certain measures like this Arogya Setu app. But what can we do going forward? So, to allay the concerns and fears, we can obviously emulate some of the global examples, some of the countries which are also using similar apps to contact trace. Arogya Setu seems to be quite popular because until now, the downloads of this app have already crossed 75 million mark, which makes it very popular. However, we need to abide by the best practices, global best practices with respect to contact tracing. If you look at EU, that is European Union, it has already laid down guidelines to effect that such apps, then the use should be voluntary. It shouldn't be made mandatory. It should preserve user privacy and should not be used after it becomes no longer necessary. That is, there should be a sunset clause which is missing in India's app. If you look at the case of Israel, the Israel had allowed its intelligence agency to trace the phone location of COVID-19 patients. However, the Supreme Court of Israel has recently struck down such emergency powers given to its intelligence agencies and has said that the agency cannot track phone location of COVID patients without enabling legislation. So there should be legislation. And similar is the case in India too. Another example that we can look is towards Australia. Australia's tracking app had sparked the privacy concerns over there also. But now the government has released a privacy impact assessment over there. That is, how much of the privacy of individuals is being compromised and how much is it really necessary with respect to the COVID-19 pandemic, that we need to go for the surveillance. So these are certain examples that India can also emulate to make its app more user-friendly and more privacy-friendly. In conclusion, the editorial says that even though the intention behind app's introduction is good because government is taking every step to limit the spread of the virus, the government should pay heed to the following things. That is, it should pay heed to the privacy concerns raised by the opposition. It should allay fears. That is, it should curb fears in the hearts and minds of the population that it may become a permanent mass surveillance instrument. You can obviously put the population on surveillance when the pandemic is there, but there should not be permanent surveillance. More than that, with respect to data, whatever data is being collected, the government should ensure that there is sufficient anonymizing of data. That is, with help of a data, nobody should be traced by their identity. You cannot trace a person with respect to his name, his family background, his address, and anything that is there in the hands of government, because then the data can be used to target the individuals, and it should also have a limited access. It is the duty of the government to resort to the above methods so that the least harm is caused with respect to privacy and individual rights. Let us move on to the key concepts now. First, we spoke about, obviously, the Arogya Setu app. It has been launched by the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. It will help in identify the risk of getting infected by the coronavirus. How is it helping in identify the risk? It will actually calculate the risk based on users' interaction with the others. Because when you have installed the app and your location in Bluetooth is on, and now how many people are you meeting? If you're test comes out to be positive, then it would be easier for the government to track all the places that you have gone to and all the people that you have met. If the other person also has the same app, then both of you can be tracked together. Now, it's using cutting edge Bluetooth technology, algorithms and artificial intelligence to track the contacts. Once installed in a smartphone, the app detects other nearby devices with Arogya Setu installed. So everybody needs to have this app installed. Only then is it possible to make the contact tracing. Now, we also spoke about the Justice Puttaswamy case, and in this case, the Supreme Court had come out with important judgment under which right to privacy was made a part of right to life and personal liberty under Article 21. And right to privacy was given the status of fundamental rights. And it held that privacy is a natural right that inheres in all natural persons. That is, if you are an individual, if you are a person, then right to privacy is your natural right and everybody has this right. Right to privacy can only be restricted by state action. That is, only government has the right and mandate to limit your right to privacy, and that too only if the government fulfills three conditions. The very first condition is that such state action must have a legislative mandate. That is, there should be a proper law guiding the government on how much privacy, right to privacy, can be compromised by the state. Now, Arogya Setu app precisely misses on this point, the first point itself. And this is where all the concerns are coming from. Second, it must be pursuing a legitimate state purpose. Now, obviously, the Arogya Setu passes the second test because it is being used for tracing the contacts of COVID-19 patients, and it is a legitimate state purpose under the given conditions. Third, it must be proportionate. That is, if state has to take such a state action, then its nature and extent both must be necessary in democratic society. Like, if you see right now, Arogya Setu app in a democratic society is need of the hour, and its nature and extent is proportionate to the fear of pandemic. So it does pass the second and third test, but it fails on the first account. So government needs to have a legislative backing for the app before its use is made mandatory by the government. Now, what are the other measures being taken by government for mass surveillance currently? Mass surveillance means tracking the population on a large scale, surveillancing the population on a large scale. And right now, government is taking many measures like this because of the fear of COVID-19. One is COVID-19 Quarantine Alert System, that is CQAS, and it has been developed by CDOT, that is Department of Telecommunication and Center for Development of Telematics, in coordination with telecom service providers. And they have developed and tested the application. It actually collects your phone data, including the device location, on a common secured platform and alerts the local agencies in case if a patient has been asked to isolate himself or herself and he ventures out of his home, this app CQAS will alert the local agency. Under Indian Telegraph Act 1885, the center is using its power, and telecom companies are providing the information to center every 15 minutes to track COVID-19 cases across the country. Under Section 5 Clause 2 of this Act, state and center have full rights to access information of a user's phone in case of public emergency such as COVID-19 that is happening right now. Another step that government is taking is Integrated Disease Surveillance Program. It is an initiative of Ministry of Health and Family Affairs, started in 2004 with assistance of World Bank. The main objective of IDSP is IT-enabled disease surveillance system in case there is an epidemic or pandemic. So COVID-19 is a pandemic, and in this, the IT-enabled disease surveillance is taking place. It helps in detecting and responding to outbreaks in early rising phase through RRT, that is Rapid Response Teams. So other measures such as airline and railway reservation data is being tracked to see how many contacts are being compromised. Then apart from this, Kerala government is using telephone call records, CCTV footage and mobile phone GPS system to trace the contacts of COVID-19 patients. And they are providing the date map showing the movement of people who have tested positive.